Okay, what's going on, guys? It is Monday, and this is going to be a beer with Salzy. I don't know if this will continue or not, just something I thought I'd try. Have you ever had one of those tournaments, or a couple tournaments in a row, where you just question your sanity of a fisherman? You're on the water and you're like, why do I do this? That's that 500-pound gorilla on your back, right? And you go from being 100% confident in your decision-making to wondering if you can still catch a fish. Now you got the little devil on that shoulder, and you got this little devil on this shoulder. This little devil is like, Ryan, you suck. Couldn't catch a fish in a bucket with 50 fish in that bucket. And this one's like, Ryan, you're the best. You know how to catch and throw right there. And after about 2,000 of throw right there, this one starts getting pulled to the dark side. He's like, I don't know if you're going to catch one now, Ryan. Might just not be your day. Well, Rayburn was kind of like that. Now, flash forward to the rat ale trap tournament on Sunday. I've been catching some rattle trap fish. Now, granted, the water did come up. It's flooding, blah, blah, blah. Been catching some great fish on a Yuzuri trap. Granted, I couldn't throw a Yuzuri. I don't think it would have made that much of a difference that day. But I had a lot of confidence in that trap before the rattle trap tournament. Long story short, I did not get a bite until 3:40. I mean, I was fishing hard. Talking pull and trolling up, run, hit a spot, fish it 15 minutes, 20 minutes, sometimes I'll fish an hour, pull it from there, burn to another spot, and I fish from the dam all the way up to Mill Creek on Gunnersville. And I did not get a bite until I pulled in Seabold at 3:40. Think about that. That is like an 8-hour fishing day, not getting a bite. And I'm supposed to be a guy pro, and you're like, I don't know if I can catch bass anymore. But end of the day, really strong. My partner caught one. Then I caught my first one at 3:40. Then the next spot I went to, I pull right up. And this is how it should be. This is how when things are clicking, this is how it should be. Pull right up, seeing a little bait, ripping my trap, doing my thing. My elbow's hurting me. And I rip that thing out, loads up. It's like almost 5-pounder. We netted it, throw it in there. I throw back out there. Trap gets fouled up, clean it off, slap it. Throw back out there, reeling. Almost to the boat, dunk, slack lines me. It's like a 3.25. Put it in the boat, and now we have 4 fish. And I'm like, man, we got a shot. We might get a check. So we grind it out at that spot for 2 more passes down this little bank. Because, I mean, you could see them on the graph. The bait was there, and you put your trap in the water, and it would just disappear. That was how muddy the water was at this spot. And what I was targeting all day was the cleaner water, or it was a little bit of transition cleaner water. So hindsight being, I guess a lot of the fish were in the stupid mud where you couldn't even see. Well, the interesting part about this was, those 2 fish in that really muddy water had it choked. So I guess the moral of the story is, don't underestimate Mr. Bass. And never give up, as Ike says. Never give up! So we're going to use that last stop momentum of the Rattle Trap Tournament and carry it forward to Harris Chain. Now Harris Chain's going to be totally different fishing. They've had a full moon. We had the super snow moon that brought snow on Saturday morning to the ABA guys. And fish are spawning in Florida. There's probably going to be some post-spawn fish. There's probably going to be fish moving up on bed. I don't know when the shad spawn happens down there. I have no idea about all that stuff. I'm not a Florida guy. But I am going to be throwing a trap. I'm going to have a reaction sweet beaver on and go flipping. I'm just going to keep it stupid simple. And hopefully I can find some fish down there and bring home a good check, because good Lord knows we need it. Because as a guide on the Tennessee River, I know you can guide a lot, but a lot of my trips have been on Pickwick. And when you're fishing the dam and catching a lot of fish up there, and people want to catch smallmouth, when it floods like this, and I'm going to throw a picture up right now of McFarland Park, it is absolutely insane how bad it's flooding. And this is Ditto Landing, too. Just crazy amount of flooding going on. When that happens, you got to reschedule your trip, or they're just going to cancel and you got to refund their money. So long story short, you don't make a lot of money as a guide if you're thinking about doing this. You don't make a lot of money if you have to reschedule trips through January and the first half of February. Call all my guide buddies. Unless you're, I don't know, unless you're Superman or Lonnie Cochran. I ain't been that booked up. Well, I have. I've literally on the books 20 trips had to reschedule. And it's just, that's bad news. That's bad news bears. So, let's go catch them in Florida, bring home some money. And if you guys haven't checked this out, this is a new bait to True Bass. This color right here is called Brent's Special. Let me pull this little swim bait off there. I ran out of my trailer, so I had to throw that. This is Brent's Special. All right, this has caught a lot of fish. The wires are bent. This is the, as known as the Frankenspin, now the BA Spinner, AKA Badass Spinner, because it is badass. Crawl it on the bottom on a ledge, crawl it through a deep lay down, brush pile, whatever you want, flat out catches them. I have caught a lot of fish, lots of fish on schools with this bait. It's something you're going to want to have in your arsenal. What you want to notice is how flexible these arms are. See that? See how flexible the arms are? That makes a big deal when you're reeling it and pulse it. And when that fish comes and eats it, those wires bend forward and he gets the hook. They'll have it just like this. Coming in your net. All right, that's all I got. Go to trueswimbaits.com, check out that, get your pre-order on. We're shipping them out, hopefully, at the end of next week. All right? So, if you want to try it out, we're doing a one-time code, NOW30, for 30% off. Enjoy some True Swim Baits, True Bass Swim Baits. Got an awesome selection of new colors. Got Hubcap, Hot Pocket, Sexy Rexy, Rexy. To name a few, we got Citron on the 3.5 if you're an Alabama rig fisherman. Amazing color that you need to throw in your A-rig. Yeah, that's all I got. Until next time, love you guys. Subscribe to the channel if you made it this far. I almost signed off without saying it. I'm really bad about not asking you, but please like this video. Subscribe to my channel. And I'm going to keep giving you shenanigans. Follow me on Instagram, albassguide_memelord. I do memes every morning. If you like that, get your daily dose of memes. And fishing shenanigans on the water, on my guide trips and traveling with FLW. All right, I'm out.